What's an algorithm? In computer science, an algorithm is a set of instructions for solving some problem, step by step. Typically, algorithms are executed by computers, but we humans have algorithms as well. For instance, how would you go about counting the number of people in a room? Well, if you're like me, you'd probably point at each person, one at a time, and count up from zero. 1, 2, 3, 4, and so forth. Well, that's an algorithm. In fact, let's try to express it a bit more formally in pseudocode, English-like syntax that resembles a programming language. Let n equal 0. For each person in room, set n equal to n plus 1. How to interpret this pseudocode? Well, line 1 declares, so to speak, a variable called n and initializes its value to 0. This just means that at the beginning of our algorithm, the thing with which we're counting has a value of 0. After all, before we start counting, we haven't counted anything yet. Calling this variable n is just a convention. I could have called it most anything. Now, line 2 demarks the start of a loop, a sequence of steps that will repeat some number of times. So in our example, the step we're taking is counting people in the room. Beneath line 2 is line 3, which describes exactly how we'll go about counting. The indentation implies that it's line 3 that will repeat. So what the pseudocode is saying is that after starting at 0, for each person in the room, we'll increase n by 1. Now, is this algorithm correct? Well, let's bang on it a bit. Does it work if there are two people in the room? Let's see. In line 1, we initialize n to 0. For each of these two people, we then increment n by 1. So on the first trip through the loop, we update n from 0 to 1. On the second trip through that same loop, we update n from 1 to 2. And so, by this algorithm's end, n is 2, which indeed matches the number of people in the room. So far, so good. How about a corner case, though? Suppose that there are 0 people in the room, besides me, who's doing the counting. In line 1, we again initialize n to 0. This time, though, line 3 doesn't execute at all, since there isn't a person in the room, and so n remains 0, which indeed matches the number of people in the room. Pretty simple, right? But counting people one at a time is pretty inefficient, too, no? Surely we can do better. Why not count 2 people at a time? Instead of counting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and so forth, why not count 2, 4, 6, 8, and so on? It even sounds faster, and it surely is. Let's express this optimization in pseudocode. Let n equal 0. For each pair of people in room, set n equal to n plus 2. Pretty simple change, right? Rather than count people one at a time, we instead count them two at a time. This algorithm does twice as fast as the last. But is it correct? Let's see. Does it work if there are two people in the room? In line 1, we initialize n to 0. For that one pair of people, we then increment n by 2. And so by this algorithm's end, n is 2, which indeed matches the number of people in the room. Suppose next that there are 0 people in the room. In line 1, we initialize n to 0. As before, line 3 doesn't execute at all, since there aren't any pairs of people in the room. And so n remains 0, which indeed matches the number of people in the room. But what if there are 3 people in the room? How does this algorithm fare? Let's see. In line 1, we initialize n to 0. For a pair of those people, we then increment n by 2. But then what? There isn't another full pair of people in the room, so line 2 no longer applies. And so by this algorithm's end, n is still 2, which isn't correct. Indeed, this algorithm's said to be buggy because it has a mistake. Let's redress with some new pseudocode. Let n equal 0. For each pair of people in room, set n equal to n plus 2. If one person remains unpaired, set n equal to n plus 1. To solve this particular problem, we've introduced in line 4 a condition, otherwise known as a branch, that only executes if there's one person we could not pair with another. And so now, whether there's 1 or 3 or any odd number of people in the room, this algorithm will now count them. Can we do even better? Well, we could count in 3s or 4s or even 5s and 10s, but beyond that, it's going to get a little bit difficult to point. At the end of the day, whether executed by computers or humans, algorithms are just a set of instructions with which to solve problems. These were just 3. What problem would you solve with an algorithm?